Right now at 5:30, we are on your side with a health alert. The Red Cross urging people to donate blood. The organization is now calling the supply issue a crisis and not just a shortage.
On your side, Riley Wyant is at a blood donation center in Henrico with a closer look at the problem and what all of us can do to help.
It's the historic dip in blood drives and blood donations that's fueling this crisis. Red Cross spokesperson Christy Carneal says the winter weather resulted in 500 donations being taken off the schedule.
It was a perfect storm. Inclement weather rolled in on top of the Omicron surge that led to a number of blood drive cancellations.
There have been businesses that maybe scheduled blood drives and then due to an uptick in the pandemic, they're going, oh wait, we need to cancel this blood drive.
The Red Cross relies on many local universities, schools, and businesses to host drives and bring in donations, but the pandemic has sent many of them remote.
Before the pandemic started, 25% of donors were between that high school and college age level. That is now at a 10% drop.
Now, as hospitals fill up and beds become more scarce, the blood supply is becoming dangerously low, and doctors and nurses have let the Red Cross know how bad it is.
They've said that they've been put in situations where maybe they've had to decide who's getting the blood for today and or do they need to save it for what could come in. And it also puts them in a position where maybe they have to make a decision that nobody ever wants to have to make.
If you are someone who cannot donate blood due to a personal or medical reason, you can help out by volunteering to either transport the blood to local hospitals or lend a hand at blood drives. The Red Cross cannot host these crucial blood drives without a certain number of volunteers. On your side, Riley Wyant, NBC 12 News.
All right, Riley, thank you.